What's up, Ambitious Immigrant? Today, I'd like to talk to you about Joel Osteen's secret to success. A lot of us have watched him on TV. He's a great pastor who does an amazing job. He almost is perfect in everything he says when he's preaching. Now, most people don't know why he got that good and some of the things he's done to become the person he is today. So in this video, I'm going to share with you his secrets and his routine, some of the things that he uses that has helped him become the person he is today. So let's first start with his struggles. Initially, Joel Osteen was struggling terribly. So he had challenges because just as usual, you know, as a pastor, you have to help so many people. The church is growing. You have a lot of folks. You have to go to funerals, to weddings, and you have to attend so many things at church that he was really overwhelmed, and he was not doing any of them very well because he was just overwhelmed, right? So too much, overworked, going here and there. And the church was not really growing the way it should have been growing. So he figured, you know what? What is this, the one thing that I can do differently besides praying, besides, wishing to change things around? So he realized that, you know, the most important thing that he was doing really was his sermon on Sunday. So on Sunday, he preaches for 22 minutes, and he realized that that was the one thing that was helping his church tremendously. And for everything else, he could have people helping him out do other things. But that one thing on Sunday, where he preaches to the entire church, and he also broadcasts live on TV, that's the most important part of his work. The one thing he should focus on very much. So one of the things that he did, and basically the way he changed his routine, is he changed everything. He stopped attending ceremonies, like such as weddings and everything else. And he started focusing on the 22 minutes of showtime. And this is something that can also be useful to you, but I'm gonna explain more about what he does differently. So basically what he's done now is change his schedule. On Wednesday, Joel Osteen basically does some research. He's looking into, you know, what is a nice topic to talk about. He's reading the scriptures, he's, you know, studying, you know, looking into the Bible and things he can just think of, you know, what's going on in the news. He's doing his research without writing anything. He's just taking notes. And then on Thursday, he basically does write everything on paper. So now it's just like, you know what? You know what you're going to talk about. Now write it perfectly on paper. And once he's written down on paper, the next step now is on Friday, he spends his day memorizing the preaching. So he just sits there with the paper written, and all he does, just the same way we used to do in school, is memorize. So basically embody the knowledge that he just puts on that paper. Then on Saturday, he does one thing differently now. So he has two services, private services, where he would preach that content twice to two different groups. He would preach the first time, and then he would adjust based on, you know, how he feels about certain things, and the second time. And then after all that, now he's ready for his preaching on Sunday. So on Sunday, he goes live. Basically, he spends, you know, the few, you know, from Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday preparing for the live show that you see on TV. And that's why he does an amazing job preaching. And it just seems like he just does that effortlessly. The one thing he's really done is he's prepared himself almost the entire week for that showtime. On Monday, he rests. So it's a break time, family time, nothing else related to church. Then on Tuesday, that's when he takes care of leadership at church, business operations and everything else. And then the same thing goes on again on Wednesday, doing more research. So the whole idea here is that he's changed his schedule to reflect the most important task, his most important activity. Most of us struggle at times, you know, we don't know, we spend time doing this and that, and we don't see much progress. So the question you need to ask yourself, what is your most important activity? What is the one thing that if you did that extremely well, you will be, you know, doing very well financially, you'll reach a lot of success. So the request here, and based on what we've learned from Joel Osteen, is take your time, change your schedule to focus on that showtime, that one thing that makes a big difference, so that your week is basically scheduled around that one activity where you have to do a great job. And some of the things it also does just shows about preparation. So it's not just thinking about what you talk about, or, you know, thinking I'm a great pastor, or I'm a great coach, or I'm a great public speaker. Let me just come straight there and I'm just going to wing it because I'm good at that. No. So it's just, you spend first time thinking about it, And then some people skip the step of writing down, but by writing things down, it allows you to think about it even more thoroughly. Because if you've written something and it makes sense of paper, it takes a lot of effort to write something down, and we all know about it. You know, it's easy to go somewhere and argue about something, but when you put that on paper, it's, you know, you have to read it, because you won't be there arguing on paper. You write it down and somebody else will read it. So you try to make sure to communicate your thoughts really well on paper. And then the practice part, right? So first you've memorized, so now you don't need the notes anymore or as much. But now, and Joel Osteen basically just comes live straight on TV and talk to people. But he doesn't just say, all right, now I've memorized, let me go live. He practices in front of a small group. So regardless of the years of experience that he has or how much he's done, he doesn't practice once, but twice. So the first time he does it, and then the second time he corrects it again. And then when he does it a third time, it's a home run. And we see the amazing job that touches a lot of souls, a lot of heart, and lots of people really feel inspired by his preaching. So I hope you can learn something about, you know, from Joel Osteen and incorporate that in whatever you're doing. It doesn't matter if it's sports that you were into, you know, if it's business, whatever it is, you know, spend some time reflecting on if there was one thing you could do extremely well and you can get help on everything else. What would be that one thing that could make a big difference in your future? Put the time in, you know, and effort into it. Spend your week focusing on it so that you're gonna produce amazing work. So I hope this is useful and you found this video very entertaining, informative, and useful for you. I'd like to thank you for your time and see you next time.